welcome to our church. My name is Jim Dant. I have the distinct privilege and honor, the humble privilege and honor of serving as senior minister here at First Baptist Church. And it is my honor to welcome you to this place tonight. You are about to be gifted with something wonderful. And it's also my honor to welcome you here to this place tonight. Among our staff, we have a mantra, and it is this: we do not do God's work. We simply create a space for God to do God's work. And we've created a space for you tonight. Thank you for being here. And I need to answer two questions. I've obviously gotten a lot of phone calls in the last couple of weeks. And I thought I would just wait and answer the two primary questions tonight. The answer to the first question is no, I'm not gay. The answer to the second question is why? And Tim, if you don't mind me preaching for just a minute, because I got a house full here. My simple answer to that each time has been because I'm a Christian and a follower of Christ. That's why. And Christ welcomed lepers and women. Christ welcomed Romans and Samaritans. Christ welcomed prostitutes and lawyers. The prostitutes we understand, but the lawyers a little harder. In fact, the only people that Jesus never was really comfortable with were self-righteous, judgmental, religious people. It's not that Jesus didn't love those people as much as he loved everyone else in the first century. It's just that they will annoy the hell out of you if you're around them too long. I am glad that you are here tonight. I am happy that the San Francisco Gay Men's Chorus and the Oakland Interfaith Choir are with us tonight. I heard them rehearse this afternoon. You are going to cry. You are going to laugh. You are going to be inspired. You are going to be brought closer to God and closer to other human beings. And if the church does that, and if we do that for one another, that's about the best the church and humanity can do. So thank you for being here tonight, and it is my distinct honor tonight to introduce to you Tim Selig, the Artistic Director of San Francisco Gay Men's Chorus. Tim.
Love this. forgot we were in a Baptist church. So I would like to enter into a period of discernment, and at the end of which we're going to take a vote. Is it okay if we continue to dance?
Destined to meet, you have more love in your life. Don't let go in. more friends than you know.
Or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. But I wonder what could happen.
You have no idea how excited we are to be here. No idea. So I'm going to tell you, I'll just tell you how excited. A whole bunch. We've been looking forward to this. Really, truly, I have, and many of the guys, more than any of the concerts we've given. And in our 8-day, 5-state tour, we've done 25 appearances in these 8 days. So, it's true. Yeah. Now, I have to explain to you why we're dressed so casually for church. My mama, God rest her soul, would be not happy with her son wearing jeans and tennis shoes in God's house. I asked God, and he said it was okay. And so we got up this morning in Knoxville, Tennessee, and we got on buses, and we drove to Greenville so we could be here with you. And when we're done, we're going to get buses again and drive to Charlotte to some motel. We're still calling to see if they'll take us. So it's a long day for us, and there was just no way to unload our luggage. You should see that. 200 gay men and their luggage. But it matches. So that's awesome. So this is not in the program, guys. This song is not in the set list that you were told by whoever your conductor is. But, Jim, I'm so sorry for the calls that you've been getting. We've been getting the same ones. The same people found out our phone number, too. It's awesome. They are precious souls, they are. And we love them. We do. Actually, however, the first question that they asked them, are you gay? They didn't ask us. So, they skipped that one. But you know, it might be the lavender shirt that you chose tonight. I don't know. It could be. I don't know. But. So. We're going to add in a little ditty just for you. This song is dedicated to you. And to question number one. Country places on our way, and we saw some country, and it was great. And I just want you to know that it's an interesting thing, because I grew up what people in California think is the South, and with each state farther east we've gone, the fewer people believe that. So it was Mississippi, Alabama, Tennessee, South Carolina, North Carolina that are like, no, you're not really from the South. I'm from Texas. And I know you people think it's a country. But people out there think it's the South. So will you, may I be a Southerner? Just, okay, wait. Oh, That was tepid. It's like, I don't know, I'll have to ask my neighbor. So I was raised, I'll tell you a little bit more about that later, by a good Southern woman, and couldn't be prouder of that heritage. So we decided that we would add a country star. And we did. I know you're like, oh, really? And so the last two shows, we had Ty Herndon, which was amazing, but he was unable to be here tonight. So we got a substitute. I think you're going to like her. Would you please welcome to the stage, on her Back to Earth tour, Miss Patsy Cline.
I've got the picture that you gave to me, and it's signed with love, just like it used to be. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the picture, and she's got you. I've got the records that we used to share, and they still sound the same as when you gave them, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the records, and she's got you. Your memory, or has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be. I've got the class ring that proved you care, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, and she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me?
Sorry, we're in church. One more thing.
I've got the class ring that proved you care, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing
Okay, if that was your favorite, you're trashy. Jim, I'm so sorry we have brought these people into your church. Right.
Way up there, where peace remains, where silence thunders and angels sing. Imagination and amazing grace bring us closer to our home in space. The stars are gathered and illuminate to lead us safely to heaven's gate. And we look behind us at the wonder of the earth, only to remind us where God gave birth. Way up there, where peace remains, where silence thunders and angels sing. Imagination and amazing grace brings us closer to our home in space.
Like a shooting star through endless time, we say a prayer for all mankind. If we could only see the dying window, we would be reborn, and we all
thank you.
for those of you who are Southern Baptists. I went from the womb to the cradle roll at the First Baptist Church of Dallas, Texas. Now, only you old people know what the cradle roll is. But they did not want us to sin as babies. So they got us right into Sunday school in a heartbeat. And I grew up there in several churches because my father is a minister and my mother is a singer. And so I grew up with the expectation that I also would be a Southern Baptist minister. My older brother was, and that was the expectation. And I followed in a different path, and that was I was first an opera singer, and then I decided I would teach college, and so I got a job at Houston Baptist University. And then they asked me to be the associate minister of music of First Baptist Church of Houston, Texas. Had a beautiful wife, two children, and the perfect picture. Absolute perfect. I worked really hard to build that. And I was absolutely miserable. Many, many, many times I was at the altar, weeping, saying, God, make me straight. Please take this yoke from me. I have a beautiful wife. I have a ministry. I have two beautiful children. I want with all of my heart to not be the thing that I know I am. One day, when I was 35, I realized that I could not live that lie any longer. And I, in a Christian counseling session, came out to my wife and the counselor. Things moved really fast in the Baptist church. You think they don't move fast. Oh, you're wrong. They can move really fast. Within, I would say, a couple of weeks, well, the next day, they had already prepared my resignation, and I was fired and lost my home, my cars. I went bankrupt, and my wife moved off to West Texas with my children, and I was left there living in a Motel 6 wondering, what am I going to do? The first night I sat in that Motel 6 knowing that I was going to lose everything with a sense of calm, because for the first time I was who God made me in my life. So that was 1986, and I had no clue what I was going to do, not a clue. And I would say that, you know, the universe, God said, hey, did you know there's such a thing as a gay chorus? I said, no, I didn't. So I found a job in Dallas, Texas with a small gay choir that I was going to stay a year. Because I was like, I don't think I can handle even the 40 gays that were in that choir. And I was going to stay a year, and I stayed 20 with the Gay Men's Chorus in Dallas, Texas. So I've been conducting LGBT choruses for the next 31 years after being in the Southern Baptist womb for 35 years. It has been the most incredible journey of my life. I have been fighting the fight, or the good fight, for those 31 years. We got a call. Well, we started reaching out to the South. You know the story, you can find it out. We started reaching out to the South saying, you know, we want to go, we want to encourage our LGBT brothers and sisters. We really picked Mississippi and your neighbor, North Carolina, because they are the worst. They're the worst, those people. Oh, those people, I don't think there's any hope for them. So, but we'll keep praying, won't we, Jim? We sure will. We were in Mississippi the weekend on Sunday when on Friday they decided to go ahead and pass HB 1523, one of the worst bills ever in our country in decades. North Carolina is struggling, but we think they're gonna get better probably quicker. So we knew we were gonna go there, and then we were trying to decide where we'd go in between. We got to Mississippi, and I got a phone call from one of our singers that said, I just found out that the First Baptist Church of Greenville, South Carolina might host our concert. And I said, you need to up your medications. I know her, and sometimes she skips them. So I couldn't believe it. So I wrote the pastor an email, and I said, dear pastor, I just want you to know that we are coming to sing. We're coming to share love. We're not coming to push anybody's buttons. It's really dry in here. And here's my Baptist pedigree. And I've been all that place that I just told you. And he wrote back and said, I don't need your Baptist pedigree. Let's talk on the phone. So we did. And he said, I trust you. So I said to him, we can leave out the fun stuff. We can leave Patsy Cline, we can leave her out. He said, don't you leave out any of the fun stuff at my church. And so it's his fault that right there. His fault. When we embarked on this tour, well, then there's one little more part of that. We came here to Greenville. We've been there now here twice before this tour, and we spent a whole day in this church. And I got to be here in a completely empty church. Nobody here, not a soul. And I got to walk up to the podium and sing my mother's favorite song, knowing that I hadn't been in a Baptist church in 30 years and she's watching. Why should I be discouraged? Why should the shadows fall? Why should my heart be lonely and long for heaven and home? I sing because in a quiet room with nobody there except my mom, you have allowed me to come home. Thank you for that. It's something. Vivian even let me direct the choir. It was awesome. It was so great. When we departed for this tour, we decided that we would leave every dollar we could raise from tickets or donations in the city where we were. And in Jackson, Birmingham, Knoxville, and Charlotte tomorrow night, all of the tickets, all of the donations are going to beneficiaries. Well, you didn't pay anything to get in now, did you? You may have just lost some of your dignity by being here, but... So we're going to take up a collection. Are you kidding? I'm an old Baptist minister. We're home free here. With the help of the church and the LGBT community, you've already seen it in your program, we chose four beneficiaries from scores of worthy ones. And they are Aid Upstate, the First Baptist Church Tragedy Relief Fund, PFLAG Greenville, and United Ministries of Greenville. So I just want you to know that you're going to give a lot. You're going to go and you're going to think, what is the most expensive concert I've ever been to? And when I went, were there 200 gorgeous men standing there? And so just figure out how many people were up there and multiply it by that. And so I'm going to make it really easy on you. Would you, ladies, get your pocketbooks? That's purses for you other people. Get your pocketbook, pick it up. I'm waiting. Uh-huh. And we're going to rise as we're able. Right, stand. This is so the men can get to their billfolds easier. And I have a number in my head. There are at least 1,000 people here. You do the math. What's this concert worth? More importantly, what do these four organizations need to do God's work in your town? We're going to do an offertory. They pass these things, and you're going to fill them. And I have a number in my head, and they're going to add it up. And if you don't give that much, we will lock the doors, and we'll be here. So deacons and ushers, come forward. And when you've given, please just have a seat. But we're on a tight schedule. We're on a really tight schedule. Oh, no, you people in the back. No. When the plate has gone by and you've given, then you may be seated. But we're going to continue with the concert while you give generously from your heart.
State, the legislature tried to regulate human nature.
And so from sea to shining sea, they'd like to tell us where to pee.
They can pass all the statutes that they please.
Acorns won't grow into apple trees.
Besides those differences they hate are the strength that made this country great
again.
West Virginia. Take the orgy out of Georgia if you must. You can't drive the Gamecocks out of South Carolina. And please leave the bear in Alabama. You can try to take the KY from Kentucky. Though I doubt that you'd get very far.
But you'll never take the color out of Colorado. Don't you realize who we are? Think of Dallas, County West, and San Francisco. Without us, they'd be America, the beautiful. Remember the fruit.
protection. Friends may depart from thee, night may come down, clouds of adversity darken and brown.
Excelsior, Excelsior,
angels to beckon me.
Across the desert with no shoes upon my feet, to share with you the last bite of bread I have to eat. I would swim out to save you in your sea of broken dreams. When all your hopes are sinking, let me show you what love means.
So loudly, every heart would understand that love and only love can join the tribes of men. I would give my heart's desire so that you might see. The first step is to realize that it all begins with you and me.
Love can build a bridge.
Between your heart and
mine, love can build a bridge.
Yes, it's time.
When we stand together, it's our finest hour.
The bridge,
your heart.
Oh, there are going to be several more standing ovations. So that was kind of the main course, but trust me, dessert is standing right. Oh, oh. No, y'all come on, no. Oh, you're waiting? Okay, go. Awesome. Don't look at those people in the robes. Don't look at them. Pretend that I'm the only one on the stage right now. So we would love to stay and hug every single one of your necks. There's a problem. We have to get out of here at 8:30 to get on the bus, because it's not about checking in late tonight, because we've been out late every night building bridges and stuff and bars. And our bus drivers have to check in by 11 in Charlotte, or they can't take us to the Interfaith service in the morning because they have to be off X number of hours. And after all the Southern food we've eaten, we cannot walk those four blocks. When we announced this tour, it was just a few days until we got a phone call from the Oakland Interfaith Gospel Choir. And they said, this is so on our mission. This is, we want to go with you. And we said, well, here's the deal. The 200 guys who are going on this tour are paying their own way. Each of them either paid or raised, each one of them either paid or raised $2,000 each in order to come on this trip. All of those people. And I said to these Oakland people, you have to pay your own way. And they said, okay. So they paid their own way to come on this tour. All of those people did. Yep. And we are so glad they did. We began rehearsing together in August, and this week we've been on buses, boats, trains, and a few Ubers for the people who missed the boat. And we could not be happier. I introduced you with all of my heart and all of my love here in Greenville, South Carolina, at the First Baptist Church, Oakland Interfaith Gospel Choir, and Terrence Kelling.
We are so excited to be here, and I'm even more excited. I can't take time because we're trying to make this bus, but I'm here with my big sister who lives in Athens, Georgia now. So my big sister, Cheryl Kelly Liggett, is going to come up and sing with us.
Holy Ghost!
happy camper am I. So the next song we're going to sing is a Negro spiritual. How many of you know that you know one? You don't know if you know? Gonna lay down my burdens down by
the river side.
So see, you do. All right, so we're going to sing one for you tonight. All right, it's called Lord, Here Come My Lord, How Come Me Here. I'm trying to talk too fast. Lord, How Come Me Here is from the standpoint of an African-American slave woman. It says, there's no freedom here. They treat me so mean here. They sold my children away. Lord, how come me here?
Born.
So after that, we have to make it better, right? So this song says better, simply better. So if you like to sing along, sing along. If you don't know the words, I'm going to give them to you. La, la, la. Now we're going to sing both choirs. How many of you throughout your life have had an orphan moment? And that means a moment where you're all alone. Whether you have thousands of friends, family, people all around you, but you still had an orphan moment. Somebody ain't telling the truth. They told me this church was Baptist. Talk back to me. Have you had an orphan moment?
Yes!
Amen. So this song says, there are no orphans of God.
Who here among us has not been broken? Who here among us?
is without guilt or pain. So oft abandoned by our transgressions, if such a thing as grace exists, then grace was made for lives like this. There are no strangers, there are no outcasts, there are no orphans of God. So many fallen, but hallelujah, there are no orphans of God. Come ye unwanted, come and find affection. Come all ye weary, come and lay down your head. Such a thing as grace exists, then grace was made for lives like this.
A party song. We have to party in 4 minutes and 42 and a half seconds. So I'm just going to ask you, if you get up now, turn on the house lights, and this song says everybody dancing, and when we get to the part that says everybody dancing, we mean it. We usually teach you some dance moves, so here you go. Wash some windows, drive your car, do the backup, do the point. Let's go.
take just a moment to give you a big hug. That was it. That was the big lobby hug we were going to give you. You're going to get home really early on Friday night. And we're going to get to Charlotte on time. What we need to ask you to do is just continue the standing ovation until the last man is out of the room. We would love to stop. Of course, people who have family members here, take some time, give them a big hug. There is no way we could thank you for this experience. I will tell you, wait. I will tell you that many of us up here have been rejected by our families, by our churches, and have moved away from our home cities. One of the most wonderful things about this tour is that we have been able to be in places where their LGBT community is becoming part of the community. And a church like this, you may be getting a lot of backlash. I almost said a dirty word. And you might be getting a lot of spit. It is nothing compared to what you have done as a shining light to all of us, to give us hope. And we want to thank you for that.